Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today I'm talking about 5 reasons why people get lumpy lips and 5 things you can do about it. So the first most important thing, we're talking about lumpy lips. It's a distinction we need to make, because if there's a bruise or pain or pustules or other problems, that's something you need to talk to your doctor about, your injector. That could be a sign of something more ominous. What we're talking about today are lumps that you can see or feel after a filler. Often these come at about day 5 to 7. They're best corrected at about 2 weeks. But let's go through the reasons and what we can do. Number one most common reason that you get lumps now is the newer products are stiffer, they're firmer, and they create more shape. They don't draw a lot of water in, but people want shape. They want to create. They want the front lip up, the upturn. They want the top lip to equal the bottom size. They want the edge of the mouth lifted up. So we're demanding more from our products, and that's why they're stiffer, have higher G primes, and often they can create bumps and lumps. Number two, the amount of product used. A lot of people look at Instagram, look at Facebook, and their goals with their filler are often equal to about 3 vials, even though they think it might be 1. And the more product we use, and the lip is a muscle, we gotta remember, so the more product, the more chance there is of getting a lump or a bump, especially with the newer products. The third reason is a small lip. When we're trying to take a small lip and create volume, like the Instagram picture they brought in, we're demanding more of our product, and we're trying to get more pink showing, more vermilion, and bring the mucosa out. And small lips tend to be more apt to get lumps or bumps because we're trying to push that pink out and create that volume, and just by nature it creates lumps or bumps. And over time, as that person gets more and more filler, they can create more lip, but it's that initial first time that often creates the lumps and bumps in a small lip. Number four is the first filler session. So it's much easier to fill a larger lip, but it's also much easier to do a touch-up lip. So when someone's first getting their lips done and we're trying to create the perfect shape, they're going to feel some product. When we touch that up, when we get the lip where we want it to be and they return in 3 months to 9 months and we're touching that up, there's a lot less chance that it's going to have a lump or bump or something that they don't like. The fifth is the nature of the lip. There is some mucosa, there is a little bit of fat, but there's a lot of muscle and dynamics. And those dynamics can move the product to areas over time that create a lump or a bump. And dynamics are very important to consider when filling the lip, when taking our pre-pictures, and in determining what we can do. Because people can have a larger lip at rest, but when they smile, they have nothing. And so we're trying to create that. So the dynamics inherent in a lip can create a lump or a bump. So what do we do? The first thing, as we said in the top, it's not an emergency taking away those ominous signs that we talked about. A painless lump that's been there for a while isn't something that has to be dealt with emergently, even though it can be to the patient because people have seen it and they see it and don't like the look, but it is an important distinction. It's okay to feel a bump, but we shouldn't see it. Feeling the bump is often part of the creation. So watchful waiting and doing nothing is just fine initially. Number two, we can dissolve the product. Most people use hyaluronic acid fillers and they can easily be dissolved with Hylenex, hyaluronidase. And just dissolving a little bit by using 5 to 15 units per bump can get rid of that in just several hours. That's the benefit of using hyaluronic acid products. But of course, if you like the product, that's also what makes it go away over time. Number three, if it is a permanent product or a longer term product, it can be surgically removed. Just like implants, sometimes people don't like the look over time and they can be surgically removed. Number four, we simply fill around it. And it's very common that either the product wasn't put lateral enough or there wasn't enough product put in, or someone came in for one syringe and we're trying to maximize what they want, wider or a narrower lip, and then there would be a step off or there's dynamics involved in the lip. Simply filling around the existing filler is a great way to treat a lump or a bump. Number five is movement, massage, and vibration, because filler goes away quicker where there's more movement. So massaging the product is fine. I usually wait for at least 7 days till all the swelling's gone and at least the product starts integrating to the tissue, which occurs more towards 2 weeks before massaging, but that can be done. It works very well and they can do it at home. Vibrating toothbrush, like Sonicare toothbrushes that create vibration, can be placed on it for a minute or two each day or twice a day, and that helps get rid of the filler as well. Patients like to be able to do things at home, especially if it's a small bump that will probably go away and progress and be gone in short period anyway, and they can do that at home to progress it quicker. So thanks for joining me today. That's lips, lumps, and bumps. I hope that's helped. Let us know your experience below in the comments section. Subscribe to this channel. Help keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.